I got a new name?
No, I got a new name for
number 22
is now Eric Henry.
Yes.
Because he is the new Eric Dickerson. Right?
All right, Eric. I'm curious. Will Derrick Henry be enough to really pull off this upset?
Well, let's start with this first. Let's look at the Kansas City Chiefs. The Kansas City Chiefs are not good against the run. I think during the regular season, they're ranked 27th. 26th against the run.
Close enough.
So they're not good against the run. And the Kansas City Chiefs is not the same football team without Kareem Hunt having a running game.
Okay.
You know, they can't control the ball. So for me, when I look at this game, you know, it's certain players, you have teams that you have their number. You know those teams. You know those teams, Skip. You just got their number. And for me, that team was the Dallas Cowboys.
I had their number really bad.
I mean, anytime we played them, I'm like, oh, I got y'all's number. I'm going to get 100. You just don't know how much I'm going to get.
Mm-hmm.
I think Derrick Henry has the Kansas City Chiefs number. You go back 2 years ago, he ran for 150 on them 2 years ago. This year, he ran for 180. I mean, and Tannehill had just got in there to be quarterback, you know. So, you know, it wasn't like he had a real quarterback to work with. But now I think he's a lot better. I think he's a pretty good quarterback. Mm. So for me, I look at this game as a game where the Tennessee Titans will control the football. They will keep Mahomes on the sideline with that pad in his hand. I mean, think about it. They went down to New England and beat Bill Belichick. What is Bill Belichick known for? Taking away your best weapon. Best weapon? Derrick Henry. They couldn't do it. The Baltimore Ravens, a team that was unbeatable. Nobody could beat. Oh, no, nobody going to beat the Ravens. The Titans don't have a chance. They go down there and beat the Baltimore Ravens. Yeah. So, to me, I'm taking the Kansas City Chiefs in this football game. And
wait, you're taking the Chiefs?
No, I'm taking the Ravens.
The Titans.
The Titans. I'm with you. You got it.
You know what I'm trying to say.
I'm everywhere.
I'm going
Titans 28-24.
Okay.
No, I agree. I mean, you make some very compelling points, but at the end of the day, is that I just don't believe Miles Turner because they predicated that taking the ball away or having short fields. They got a pick six against New England, and they got 14 points off a turnover from the Baltimore Ravens. The question is, can you go into Kansas City, minus those turnovers, and win a game? See, I believe you need to get to 30. If you look at New England last year, Skip, it got to 30, what, 30, they end up winning in overtime. Mm-hmm. Well, when they, Sonny Michel ran, no, that's Burkhead that scored that mm-hmm. touchdown. But so I believe you got to get to that number. The question is, can Kansas City make it a game between Patrick Mahomes and Ryan Tannehill as opposed to Derrick Henry versus Patrick Mahomes? Mm. Because the Titans try to limit your possessions, especially if you can score. And that's what Kansas City can do. They got 28 points in under 10 minutes, which there are very few teams in the NFL that can do that. Some teams can't get 28 in a game.
Yep.
In two games, they got 28 in 10 minutes. They've got to force Derrick Henry. You got to make him check. ED, you know this. You got to make him stutter. If you let that man go 1, 2, 3 through the line of scrimmage, he's gonna fall for 7 yards. And he's going to keep Patrick Mahomes in it. That makes you get antsy.
Mm-hmm.
So now he'll start taking unnecessary risks. Guys get antsy, well, I got to make a play because I don't know. I got to make a play. And you get drops like you got last week. They started the game third down, like 3 consecutive drops because guys like, they went down and scored. The Texans went down the field and scored. Okay. Whew, I got to go. Oh. Next thing you know, they score again. And then they block a punt. And so now they got the anxiety level raises because you know, you're right that maybe got the Super Bowl. We one game away from the Super Bowl. This is what you work for all year. But I got the Chiefs. I believe they're going to win big. I got it 33-20 because I don't believe Tannehill's going to be able to keep up.
You better hope that's the score. Because you gave me 10 points. I got the Titans plus 10.
Oh.
And I got my man Eric Dickerson saying Titans are going to win it outright with no points.
No point.
I can't believe I'm about to say what I'm about to say. But right now, Derrick Henry is a greater force than Patrick Mahomes. Even at Kansas City, Derrick Henry is the greater force on the football field. And we've heard for 5, 6 years about the devaluing of the running back position.
Thank you.
Yep.
That lie they told.
And all of a sudden, here comes this guy, and I've never seen anything like this guy. And you keep saying, bigger body of work.
Yeah.
And then he does it again, and he does it again, and he does it again, and you still could be right. Maybe he needs 2 more games to show you he's that guy.
No, Skip, I need a bigger body of work as far as sample size in the regular season. I mean, he had a great 8-game stretch. Or last year, he had a great 6-game stretch. Mm. But to be, you know, ED, you know you got to be top. You got to do that thing over a complete season.
He's got to do it over and over, but you know, he's doing it in the playoffs.
Oh, yeah.
Think about it. Like that, I said, he did it against Bill Belichick's football.
I mean,
and that was supposed to be a great defense, supposedly.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's what helped TD get into the Hall of Fame. Yeah, he had a short NFL career, but you look at him in the playoffs, Terrell Davis. Yeah. You look at him in the playoffs, 7 of his 8 games was over 100, and the 7th game was 91.
And a lot of people knocked him for a very short career,
right.
But he's in the Hall of Fame. And this guy's on a Hall of Fame arc, I got to tell you, because what enlightened me the most was a week ago, this man telling me that he happened to run into Derrick Henry at a card show in Chicago.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And you said, wait a second, I think he's like 6'4 and a half, 260.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, that's a big man.
Okay. This was a big man because this man went 6'3, 225-ish, right?
25.
Right in there. And all of a sudden, we've taken it up a whole nother evolution of power and speed, because when this guy hits the hole, there's burst to it.
Right. Mm.
And I've been saying it, and it hurts my heart to say it. This guy's better than my guy, than Ezekiel Elliott. He's just better right now. I mean, what does your eye test tell you when he hits the hole?
You better get out the way.
You better get out of the way because he's going to carry people with you. He's going to punish you all game long until in the fourth quarter, you don't want to tackle him anymore.
Skip, you know who he reminds you of? He might be a bigger Brandon Jacobs.
Okay.
You remember Brandon Jacobs from the Giants?
No, I think Brandon Jacobs was like 250 or 60.
He might be bigger than Brandon Jacobs. Skip, I'm telling you, when I saw him in October when they played the Titans played the Broncos, and I'm standing on the sideline and I'm looking at him. I'm like, ain't no way that man 247. I'm 245.
But I'm telling you, when you see him, he just I was like. Dang, I told him, you a big running back. I mean, you know when you're going down the highway, in the open highway, and all of a sudden, you hear, the diesel truck coming.
Yeah.
What you mean? You better get out the way.
Yeah.
You better get out. That's what he like a big diesel. They say, here come Mac time. You better move on over because this is a big man.
Brandon Jacobs lumbered into the hole.
Yeah.
He just did it on sheer physicality and size and strength. This man can move.
Yeah.
Yep. And if you give him a crack, any kind of crack, he's got acceleration.
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah.
I mean, I don't know what he runs the 40 in, but with the football.
I think he ran 4.5.
But he looks quick to me. He looks like he has real burst in the hole.
It was good. The guy got a 99 yard on his resume. He got a 68 yard on his resume. He got some long TD runs. You don't break long TD runs running 4.9.
No, okay. If you get the DBs, they don't want to be in the front. They trying to get behind.
To the side. Yeah, get the get back. Ezra Thomas.
Which brings me back to the quarterback of the Tennessee Titans, who has become the most underrated quarterback in playoff history since that guy, who's that number 12 guy who played for the Patriots back in 2001 out of the 6th round, Michigan. Remember that guy?
Oh, that guy.
Oh, wasn't that Steve Grogan? Oh, Steve Grogan, 14.
He was a little before that. That Brady guy. All of a sudden, this Tannehill guy, for whom I had little to no respect when he was a Dolphin, I didn't have respect for him before his draft.
The Dolphins didn't have any respect.
They dumped him. All he did was, by Pro Football Focus, have the best year of any quarterback. Now, you say, well, it's only 11 games. But it was 11 games. And Pro Football Focus says he was the best quarterback in football in those 11 games. Not volume throwing, because he doesn't throw many passes. Mm-hmm. Quality of those attempted.
Right.
And for those who have forgotten, at New England, he completed only 8 of 15 passes for 72 yards, and they won the game.
Yeah.
But he made the throw at the end of the game on 3rd and 8 from the 15-yard line to ice the game to another one of his no-name tight ends. And then he goes to Baltimore, and he goes 7 of 14 for 88 yards. But he made 2 throws that just knocked the lights out in Baltimore.
Yep.
One to his another no-name tight end, and then one to some little kid from Holy Cross who can fly, right? So he's got weapons that you don't know, and the unutilized weapons are the two kids. A.J. Brown and Corey Davis are really good receivers, and they barely catch any passes unless you don't guard them, unless you get a little too 22 conscious, and all of a sudden the reason Ryan Tannehill is so hot-handed, not throwing many passes, is because play action, they're stacking the box.
It's a real play action.
They're going like 10 in the box,
right?
Right? Because you have to, after a while, just stack it and stack it. Say, we got to stop him.
Got him.
And all of a sudden, one of these guys is going to get loose.
Get
somewhere,
one-on-one coverage.
Somebody's going to get one. Yeah. And Ryan Tannehill has a big arm, and he's a big kid. He's like, he's not a kid anymore, but he's 6'4", played receiver at Texas A&M. And all of a sudden, he's looking like Tom Brady early on in New England.
Well, Skip, I think the thing is for Kansas City, they're going to have to make Ryan Tannehill a worker, not a manager. You got to make him work. Because right now, he's just managing the store. He ain't doing no work. Mm-hmm. Derrick Henry doing all the legwork, Skip. He's doing all the labor. So you got to make Ryan Tannehill, okay, Ryan Tannehill, we got to get you somehow to throw 30 passes. We got to make
you
push.
If you can do that, you got to shot.
Yes, yes. You got to make him work. Because right now, he's just managing. Mm. He ain't doing no work, Jenny. Mm.
But it didn't have to because.
I know, but I'm going to make
it. The thing is I'm going to talk about the Titans offensive line. When you run the football, offensive line really gets into it. I watch them. I mean, just like I remember when we ran the football. They're like, come on, let's keep running this ball. You guys keep running. Right. Let's keep running the football. And, you know, like you said, the play action is really play action. Mm-hmm. I mean, because they have to come up and respect Derrick Henry. Right. They have to. And it's going to make it makes Tannehill that much better when a running back is a quarterback's best friend.
Yeah.
I mean,
you look at that one that you talked about that he threw over the top. You look where Earl Thomas is. You look at the free safety that's in the hole because Marlon Humphrey think he has help to the hole because he's jumping outside. And the safety, because Henry, he had just broken up.
He left them looking at each other like, what are you doing?
Marlon Humphrey looking at him, bro, where you at? You in the hole. You the hole safety.
Where supposed to be at?
Interesting.
To me, that's the problem with when I think about Mahomes because they don't have that.
No.
They don't have – they rely strictly on – throwing the football.
Their short passes is the run game.
Right, that's it. And, you know, we have to run it because we have to, but they can't sustain those long drives.
Right.
You know, this isn't the Houston Texans defense. The Tennessee Titans have a good defense. I mean,